Hello, everyone. I want to start by congratulating everyone who took part in the challenge. You've all done amazing work as part of this initiative. I also want to specifically thank a few people who are here with us today. We've got David Walmsley from the Globe and Mail, my colleague, our Finance Minister, Bill Morneau. And finally, thank you to Killian Birtz and Jim Leach for inviting me to join you at the Infrastructure Summit. The people in this room know that infrastructure projects are about more than just adding a new subway line, fixing an old bridge, or buying houses or buses. For the people of Toronto, the Portlands Flood Protection Project means flood protection and a revitalized city space for generations to come. For parents living in Calgary, the Green Line means less time in traffic and more time at home. For les familles de Gatineau, le prolongement du Rapibus améliorera la qualité de l'air en réduisant le nombre de voitures sur les routes. Infrastructure is about growing our communities. It's about making our towns and cities better places to live, not just today, but for generations to come. But in order to do all that nowadays, public and private sector investors have to modernize our approach to infrastructure planning. Our world is constantly evolving, and the rapid pace of change is disrupting existing models. Some of our big cities have had their populations double and their boundaries expand. As a result, the demand for things like affordable housing and efficient transit remains high. Meanwhile, major advances in technology have completely changed the way governments and businesses respond to these changes effectively and efficiently. To meet demand, we have to constantly innovate and consider the bigger picture. C'est exactement ce que vous avez fait ici au sommet de l'infrastructure. Votre présence témoigne de votre engagement à transformer la façon dont nous approchons les projets d'infrastructure et surtout d'en parler. Et c'est une discussion très importante que nous devons avoir pas seulement entre membres d'un même cercle, mais à travers les différents secteurs. Avec les citoyens, la société civile et les intervenants. Nous devons impliquer le plus de gens possible dans la discussion parce que nous avons besoin de perspectives diverses pour mieux répondre aux demandes des citoyens et arriver à de meilleurs résultats. To modernize infrastructure planning, our government adopted a challenge approach, similar to the one featured here today. As part of the Smart Cities Challenge, the Government of Canada invited communities across the country to develop an ambitious plan to improve the lives of their residents. Local businesses, innovators, and entrepreneurs were asked to work across sectors to imagine creative solutions to the problems we're facing. The most promising designs will then receive funding to bring those ideas to life. Part of our infrastructure plan was to help move new projects forwards more quickly and grow our communities now, not 10 years from now. And that's why we created the Canada Infrastructure Bank. The bank is a way for us to leverage private capital and help our dollars go further. Et sur ce point, je tiens à saluer Pierre Lavallée, président directeur de la banque, Janice Fukakusa, présidente de la banque, et Jim Leach, conseiller spécial. À la banque. We can applaud them. They've been working very, very hard. Grâce à leurs compétences diverses et leur connaissance du domaine de l'investissement et du secteur, nous sommes confiants qu'ils feront de ce nouveau projet un grand succès. And while we're off to an exciting start, we know that we need to keep up the momentum. The possibilities are endless when it comes to propelling ourselves towards the future, especially when you consider the latest technologies. Yesterday, I met with the Prime Minister of Estonia, who shared his country's experience with digital governance. They've harnessed the latest technology to promote transparency, empower citizens, and improve government services. And this is just one example of the transformative power of technology. It can be applied to virtually anything, including infrastructure planning. But while we continue to innovate and to create, we can't lose sight of the very real impact these changes have on Canadians. Businesses and governments cannot neglect the responsibility they have towards the people who work for them or those who elect them. The Government of Canada made significant investments in skills training so Canadians can take on the jobs of tomorrow. This is a challenge faced by countries around the world. That's why we decided to make it a central focus of the upcoming G7 summit, which will take place next week in Charlevoix. Les dirigeants seront appelés à innover, à faire preuve de créativité et à apprendre les uns des autres. J'ajouterai également que le thème d'égalité des sexes et l'analyse comparative entre les sexes seront intégrés dans l'ensemble des thèmes, des activités et des résultats de notre présidence. Qu'il soit question d'économie, d'emploi ou d'environnement, les solutions formulées non seulement par les membres du G7, mais bien par tous les dirigeants de tous les secteurs doivent promouvoir la participation et l'autonomisation des femmes. Le secteur de l'infrastructure n'y fait pas exception. Les efforts s'inscrivent dans notre engagement à moderniser les façons de faire et à propulser notre pays vers l'avenir. When I look around this room, I see people who share our government's ambition to make our towns and cities even better places to call home. Canada needs people like you who are ready and willing to innovate and seize new opportunities. So keep up the great work. Know that this government shares your enthusiasm for the future. And once again, thank you very much for inviting me here today to be part of this celebration, CanInfra Challenge. Merci beaucoup, mes amis. Thank you so much.